Grand National just went by. I don't have a single camera to catch it. Damn it. Well, forward one did, maybe. Zoom in heavy, might be able to get them. Alrighty. Stopped at a rest area for a quick potty break. We're getting ready to go on to Council Bluffs. Like one of them twisty slides, like at a kid's, you know, park. And a generator on the front end of that. He's got that generator tied down. Look at that. Why would you strap over the weak sheet metal of a generator when you have tie down points on the fuel tank for chains? They're way more solid than them straps, and you don't have to risk bending the metal. Cheap truckers aren't skilled. Skilled truckers aren't cheap. I mean, it's not an unsecured load, it's a potentially damaged load. on the local lane side. Right here. I wonder how much they paid for somebody to weld all that scrap metal on both sides of the bridge here as modern art. It's been that way for a long, long time. There's a pilot over there too. Yep, still there. Been there for a long time. And now that I think about it, I've always remembered this place. I remember watching live on television the Twin Towers on 9/11 falling. I remember watching it live. Was that the pilot? Back then they had the TVs on display, you know, the 12-volt televisions putting the some were DVD players, I guess, and others were VHS tapes, like a TV-VCR combo. They had them on display, and I watched the towers fall live, sitting at that pilot. I remember that day I woke up in York, Nebraska, in the Petro, and I started headed east. I was leased on with Landstar. I had a reefer trailer that it was mine, and I had a load of honeydew melons on coming to Hunts Point, New York. Set delivery date of September 12th. No, we're in Nebraska now. I got the big boy locomotive up there, along with the other diesel. I forget which one is that. 4023. And that diesel, I don't remember what its number is. I remember, I never knew it. Anyway, yeah, I woke up on the morning of the 11th early in York and started driving east. Somewhere between here and there, when at the time my wife called me and told me that a plane hit a building and it was on TV. And then I'm like, how the hell is that possible? How did they know to put the cameras on the building? Well, it turned out she was looking at the second impact, not the first. Everybody knows the rest of the story on that day. Remember, I was a considerable ways into Iowa. Might even have been Illinois. Saw the multiple contrails of an aircraft, multiple aircraft heading eastbound. That was after they grounded all the aircraft. The only planes allowed to fly were the presidential plane, you know, Air Force One, and the escort aircraft that went with it, fighter escort. That was was when Bush left from wherever that bunker was, went back to D.C. Heck, it might even have been in Indiana. I don't remember where I was. I just remember seeing the contrails up in the air. says. See if we get our free pass. Bypass. We'll stop in and say hi. Alrighty, boys and girls, I got done eating lunch here. The Petro in York, Nebraska. Just had me a little salad. Just had myself a little salad.
Alright, brother, come on.
Now it's time to get trucking. If we can get out of the truck stop. Was waiting for the bull rack, but he's waiting for the bull rack a mile from where the bull rack is. And he's got her made. Lined up nice and straight. People when you go to the store, maybe three, as far as like waiting in line, right? You got some people that wait in line, like the line's here, they'll be over there. Now, like, if you're gonna wait in line. If you're not gonna wait in line, then, you know, if you can stand over there, leave a huge gap between you and the person in front of you, well, and I don't know if you're in line or not. And people were goofy like that before COVID, so. Kind of same thing there.
I didn't know he was waiting for a bull rack, but all the same time, bull rack was literally 300 feet from him. Another camera on the back of my mirror facing rearward. We're on 80. It's where all the 80 is kind of typical, where you see all the big old large cars. I hope I get some pictures and video of some cool looking large cars getting on down the line. For.
Cab over is that Gentry bought. He just bought two of them. Freightliner Argosy's. Cat powered. Personal family stuff, and that stuff's gotta stop. But I'm one guy in one truck trying to keep running at a constant rate. And my older boy did just visit. And then I got to go see Matthew, and Sean ought to come out too to California. Take some family time. Trying to figure out how to make it all work out. Got Thanksgiving coming up, Christmas coming up. I don't really have a plan on either. But we'll see what comes up come Christmas time. I know I don't do good being home for holidays. My family has moved out, you know, my children are grown and out of the house. So it's not the same. I grew up with big, huge family gatherings. Yeah, not anymore. Mom and Dad are in Texas, next to my sister. Drama between me and my sister does not make for a good visit to Texas. Straps on that either. You know, straps to go up, over, and down through the first layer, then more through the second layer, more through the third layer. I didn't see a single belly strap. Like you put the first layer, run a couple straps, put the second layer, run two or three more, put the third layer and run. But I'd be doing it with chain, not just strap. I had a headache, Rat, but those things aren't stopping steel. Not like you think they do. Stuff like that's why you get nervous about hiring drivers. I always forget to talk about it. You know, FSC Trucking does have a page on Facebook. You guys should check it out. I want to try to grow there a little bit, try to push it a little harder, try to grow the brand a little bit. I don't know. I'm 45 years old. I don't know how to work Instagram, so that's not really my thing. Maybe I ought to learn. I don't know. I don't have a TikTok. To be honest, I don't want anything to do with TikTok because I know who owns them. This is why I wish I was able to get the 355 rear ends rather than the 370s. Get the truck up to about 70 mile an hour and not really worry about it much. It'll do 70, just the engine's screaming. It sounds pretty, like the revs are way too high. Would be nice. Wasn't available! I can always change them in the future, it's not a big deal. Under it too with an overdrive. This is a direct drive, pretty sure anyway. So, and I got 24 low pro tires on it, so I could go to 24 tall, but then the trailer gets too damn tall high off the ground. I like it the way it is. Things I think about. Okay to bypass. He passes off though. lined up on the plate, don't they? Oh, the bypass lane is... Well, they don't have one anyway. But the Loves for parking. It ain't even 6 o'clock yet. To get to Denver from here. Jay, might get lucky, but I wouldn't hold my breath. Wired.
Friday, boys and girls. Obviously, it is the next day. I started up the truck this morning. I came over to the Loves because we were at the Flying J. I'm not a fan of the Flying J at all. This Loves parking lot is an absolute excrement show. But makes you wonder. They're jumping over each other to get into the Loves. The Flying J lot is half empty. What does that tell you about the trucking industry's opinion of the Pilot, the Loves, and the Flying J? They're killing themselves to get in here. So that tells me something. All right, so with that, let me go ahead and get everything shut down and fired up. We got about 3 hours-ish till Denver. Today's Sunday. We got kind of hanging out all day Monday. I went to upload a video this morning. Service here for my little air card hotspot. It's terrible. So in literally 30 minutes, I got 2%. So I just canceled the upload. I'll do it in Denver. That's Tuesday's video anyway. Today's video is already scheduled to drop tonight. So I have plenty of time to get that upload done. All right, with that, let's get rocking. Kind of feel bad I tell a dude how to go, but the camera's running, we do gotta scroll. All right, let's cut the APU and get the main engine started. Green APU is off. Caterpillar is on. I had it running earlier to come here. Sat here a little bit, had my salad, got my OJ, we're good to go. Get a lot of comments about the where's your seat belt? It's a lap belt only, it's an 84 model truck. While we wait here to come up, play Cinepril for blood pressure. Advil for the hurting back. The back's hurting again. The wicked jump on the razor and I bottomed out and hurt myself. Those are the pictures for that day. And then Sean jumped his Jeep. Crazy son of a gun. What fun. I know you're not gonna park, right? Because I'm trying to leave. That is too. All right, hey, Stevens, if you want an easier hole, wait for me to pull out. This way. Older gentleman over there, subscriber. Has little dog, little chihuahua, Mia. Mia's very shy. If she meets drivers, she don't know whether she's gonna get petted or kicked. Said some driver kicked her, so now she don't know what she's gonna get when she meets a driver. Now unless the dog's biting on you, you don't need to kick on no dog. That's just straight cruel.
But she figured out I was friend, not foe. Of course, I always make the joke that I got an agreement with dogs. It's real simple. Don't bite me, I don't bite you. I got teeth too. Lady over there got a big old dog. And you're a horse. I know you want the smoke show. Let's roll that beautiful coal footage. This pickup does. That's all the runway we have. Still the one stack crew over here. One functional stack, one fake stack. Those newer to the channel, that's because when we installed the green APU, my exhaust on the right side was in the way. So we cut it off and I capped the Y pipe off with a piece of the pipe that I had cut off, ironically. And I haven't been back home to redo the exhaust system. We did while waiting on this load. We did replace the differentials in the truck. Far more important. Everybody busts my chops about my rear wheels. Well, the truth is, I really don't want to worry about spending that kind of money right now when I just literally just got done spending a fortune putting two diffs in the truck, having to have Gen Drive all over the world to bring them to me, on top of many other family obligations I got going on. Now, if there is a rim company out there that wants to work with a guy like myself, work that price down, that'd be awesome. side. The only reason I mentioned probably DOT is speed limit 75, so I didn't really think they got them for speed. About doing them random inspections on the side of the road. If it's illegal to park there, it should be illegal to work there too. People get ran over doing stuff like that. When you could have just went, 20 miles further east to an actual rest way station area where that stuff's supposed to be done. Seems safer to me. Pitiful if that's considered a wide load, but it is.